today I'm going to guide you through my favorite class of all that I love to practice and teach, stretch and de-stress. And it's named that because that's what we're going to do. Some really nice gentle stretching and some perfect relaxing end of the day de-stressing, which we all need. So we'll start out sitting in easy pose. If this is uncomfortable, to your knees, to your lower back, it helps sometimes to put like a couch cushion under your bottom to lift your hips up a little higher. If your knees are up high, it makes no difference. As long as it's comfortable, you can be like that. You can even sit in a chair for this beginning part. Whatever's sustainable and comfortable. And you can watch me or just close your eyes for this beginning part. So start sitting up nice and tall, feeling the crown of the head lifting gently up towards the sky. So we're putting some length in between the vertebrae of our spine. Close your eyes and start by taking a few deep, slow breaths. Just like if you were getting a checkup and the doctor asked you to take a deep breath and let it out. Just let your breath naturally come and go. As we move through the practice, we're going to keep our focus here in this present moment, noticing how our breath feels coming in and out of our body, how it sounds, what we can see and feel right now in this moment. So we feel the breath coming in and expanding us, filling us up. We feel ourselves deflate and soften as the air leaves. Keep that going. All the little spaces that your breath gets into and feel them expand. And feel your body softening and relaxing every time you exhale. One last breath here in stillness. And as you exhale, lower your head forward as though you're looking at the floor, letting your chin fall softly towards your chest, but without any strain in the neck. Take a breath here and notice how heavy your head is, and feel that stretch down the back of the neck and through the trapezius muscles that stay so tight all day. And now we'll roll the head around in circles as we breathe. So inhale, bring one ear towards one shoulder, let your head fall to the back, around to the other side, and as you exhale, let your head fall forward nice and heavy. And go around again. Nice and soft, letting your breath move your neck around. One more time around. At the end of that circle, pause here and switch directions. Pull the other ear to the other shoulder. Let your head fall back, around to the other side, and exhale, let it fall forward. And again. Feel the stretch in each side of your neck, through the back of your neck, and even through the front of your throat. As you exhale, let your head fall forward, and then pick your head back up to neutral, and let's roll the shoulders. So inhale, lift your shoulders up high by your ears, pull them back a bit, exhale, let them all the way down, and again. We're only moving with the muscles of the shoulders, so everything else is just relaxed. You might even feel your arms and hands being dragged and forth. Back and forth along your thighs. One more. Let that relax. Now pick your hands up. Rest your hands up on top of your shoulders. And we'll circle the elbows. Circle. Inhale the elbows forward. Reach them up as high as your elbows will go. Pull them back. And exhale them all the way down and relax. And again, inhale. Exhale, release. Keep that moving, just moving exactly into where it feels good to move and to stretch. One more. At the end of that circle, just switch directions. Inhale, elbows pull back and up. Exhale them forward and down. We're not trying to reach any certain point here, we're moving into a place where it feels good, where it feels better than what we did before. One more breath. Sigh that down. Let go of your shoulders. Let your arms hang down. Feel all the blood and energy draining back down into your forearms and palms and fingers. And with our next breath, let's lift an arm up. Inhale, one arm out to the side and up towards the ceiling, reaching a little bit or a whole lot, whatever feels good. Exhale that arm all the way down. When you need to breathe again, breathe the other arm up, reaching, and exhale that arm. Keep that moving as we breathe, as though our arm has no effort of its own. We're just moving with our breath. One more on each arm. Breathe. And exhale the arm down. Last time, inhale it up. Exhale all the way down. Nice and soft. Next breath, inhale, both arms straight up towards the sky or your ceiling, reaching high. Exhale, gently twist to one side, twisting through the waist, arms softening out to the side. And inhale, face forward again, arms lift up, and exhale to the other side. That's all. We're going to keep that moving. Just one continuous flowing movement. It's just like when you move your arms through water, you feel the resistance of the water. Same thing right now, it's more subtle, but you can feel the resistance of the air. It's kind of cool, prickly on your skin. Last time, inhale, face forward, arms lift up, and exhale, bring your arms straight out in front of you. So your palms are facing each other, arms parallel to the floor. And as you inhale, open the arms wide out to the sides, hands pulling back as far as they comfortably go. And exhale, bring them back together in the front, reaching forward with your fingers. And then breathe again, breathe them open. We're opening the chest and the front shoulders here. And exhale them back together in the front. Every time we inhale, we're opening the chest. And every time we exhale, we're opening the upper back between the shoulder blades. One more like that. And exhale, close. And relax your arms. Let them come down into your lap. Shake them out if you need to. Now bring both legs straight out in front of you. They don't have to be together. They can be. They can be a little bit apart. Doesn't matter. One thing I want you to take note of is your spine. We're going to stay in neutral spine, just like we're standing up nice and tall, just to protect our back. So your hands can come here in your lap or down here up next to you. If your back is achy, bring your hands back here to support you. That's fine. We're just going to flex and point the feet while tightening all the leg muscles as we breathe. So inhale, flex the feet back. Your heels might even lift off the floor. Exhale and point, squeezing your calves. Keep that moving. Inhale, feel how tight your thighs are. And exhale, point, stretching out the shins and the tops of the feet. Two more breaths like that. Inhale. Exhale. One more. This kind of exercise, keeping the legs tightened like this, is really good for knee health too, if you have any knee problems. Now relax the legs. Relax them and shake that out. Now we're going to take one leg. Bend it, bring it in. The sole of the foot will stay on the inside of this leg, or if it feels okay, cross it over. Crossing the leg over gives a little bit extra stretch in the hip, but if that doesn't feel good, keep it right here. It's the same move. So we're going to hold on to this knee with the opposite hand, or even the elbow, if that reaches. Don't strain for it. If it's just your hand, that's fine. Other hand comes around. Breathe, and we're going to gently twist to the side and hang out right there, letting the whole body be soft and be passively stretched. The more you relax the hip here, you're going to feel that stretch in the hip of the cross leg. One more breath here. exhale, come back to facing straight ahead. Uncross the leg. Let that knee fall open to the side. Now, if this is uncomfortable and it hurts your knee, or it puts a strain on your back or your hip in any way, prop something up under here. You can put a pillow, a folded up towel, a yoga block, whatever you've got. And then we're going to face the straight leg. Flex this foot back. Sit up tall. Take a breath in. And as you exhale, we're folding forward slightly. We're not trying to touch the toes. We're not trying to bring our nose to our knee. We're bringing our belly a little bit closer to the top of the thigh. And the goal is not what we look like here. The goal is feeling the stretch down the back of the leg, stretching the hamstring and the calf. And when you're feeling that, stay there. You're right where you need to be. Instead of pushing our upper body down, flexing the foot brings a lot of that stretch into play. And then breathe right here. Imagine you're breathing right into the back of your leg, helping it to soften with every breath you let out. One more breath here. Let it out. With the next breath, inhale the arm that's opposite your straight leg. Lift it up, a little bit of a twist through the waist, open that arm. Exhale, come back to the leg with both arms. And then again, inhale, open, and exhale, back to your leg. Keep that moving. Next breath, inhale the same way, starting out the same way, but we're going to bring this top hand all the way back behind us, press it into the floor, lean into it a little bit, open up with the other arm, big stretch of the front of the body, exhale both arms back to your leg, and just keep that moving, breathing in, and letting all your breath out, coming back to your leg. Is this the kind of move let yourself get lost in, because there's no rule. There's not really any way to do it wrong. We're just breathing and moving to the rhythm of our breath, just like if you were dancing. One more like that. And exhale. Rise up away from that straight leg. Bend it. Help it in. Bring it in. Other legs turn to come out straight. The bent knee, again, the foot will stay either on the inside of this leg, and it doesn't matter how close in you bring it. Go to where it's comfortable. Cross it over if you want, and if you don't want to, leave it right there. That's okay. Opposite hand holds onto that bent knee, and if you twist far enough, maybe it's your elbow that grabs. I don't know. I usually do it this way. It just depends on your body. Other hand comes around. Take a breath. And let it out, gently twisting to the side. Remember, this arm is the only thing really doing any work. It's helping us twist around. The hips, the thighs are loose, letting go, letting yourself be passively stretched. Go back and feel the breath if you've forgotten to keep noticing it. Straight ahead. If the leg is crossed, uncross it, and then we'll just let it flop open to the side. And remember, if it's up here and it's feeling like this hip is tight and straining your lower back, stuff something under there to help support it so you're not straining. Face the straight leg. Important part, flex your foot back, because that's going to put a lot of the hamstring and stretch into this one. Sit up tall, breathe in, and exhale. Folding forward slightly, keeping our back pretty neutral. I'm going to turn sideways so you can see my back. So I'm trying to keep my back from rounding here. I'm folding forward this way, and that's as far as I need to go. My hamstring is stretching as much as it needs to right now, and I do this every day. This is as far as I need to go. So go to where your stretch is. One more breath right here. Next breath, inhale that opposite arm of the straight leg, lift it up, Open, a little bit of twist through the waist. Exhale, come back to your straight leg. Keep that moving. Inhale, open. Exhale, soften and close. Inhale, open all the way up. I'll turn sideways. This top hand's going to come back behind you. Press it into the floor. Lean into it. Other arm opens and stretches. Exhale, come back to the left. See from all sides what we're doing. And that's it. You can watch your screen. You can close your eyes. You can hear outside. Look at the sky. Look at the ground. Come up onto hands and knees. So we're coming into tabletop, and here I like to tell people to get something squishy. You can get a blanket or a folded up towel if you're on a hard floor and the mat is thin, just to protect your knees. Always taking care of yourself. There's no reason for your knees to hurt here. So coming into tabletop, because that's what we look like. Hands are pretty much right below the shoulders. The knees are stacked right below your hips. And the spine is pretty neutral. So look down at your mat. We'll come into some cat-cow. Take a breath in. And as you exhale, the ground pushing your back into cat, the way a cat arches its back and stretches. And inhale, coming into cow. Get that arched, sway back. And exhale and round. Keep that moving. An achy back, when I've been traveling, when I haven't done yoga in a week or two, my back starts hurting, and this is my go-to move. Nice and gentle, very slight, and this helps me start feeling better. One more breath in, and exhale out. Come back to neutral spine. Now we're going to pick up one leg straight out behind you. Whatever leg that is, I'm using my left leg right there, but whatever leg is out, put it right out behind you with your foot flexed, toes pointing down to the floor as though you wanted to stamp the wall behind you. You can stay right here or you can add to this. And if you want to add, you'll add your opposite arm. So I have my right arm, left leg pulling. And we're pulling that raised arm and leg in opposite directions. Fingertips and heel pulling away from each other. And keeping your breath nice and steady. And that's the hard part, more than doing the move. It's the breathing, remembering to exhale. And I can guarantee you, you're shaky here, because I am. And that's normal. The shaking isn't something we're going to overcome. The shaking is something that means our body's trying to help us balance. So we're going to breathe through it and be okay with the shaking. One more breath. Pulling in opposite directions. Exhale, let everything down. And then switch. Whichever leg was up before, keep it down. Stick the other leg out. And you can even look upside down and see your flexed foot. You see your toe is pointing straight down to the ground, so they're not out to the side. Get your balance here, be steady, stay here, or if you want to add more, add the opposite arm. And when I'm in the studio, I like to use blocks, like a block right here to put my hand on to balance. Or if you're at home, just, you can do it right next to the couch. Use the couch for balance. That's not cheating, that's helping yourself. That's okay. So reaching and breathing. One more breath here. Exhale, let everything come back down to the floor, back to tabletop. next breath, take one arm, doesn't matter which one, inhale it out to the side, and we're lifting it up slightly. It's not going to go all the way up. Exhale, thread that arm through between your knees and other arm, over towards the other side, and then inhale, sweep it back up, and exhale that arm through. And just keep that going. And your arm, it's just like the thinnest, tiniest branches up in the top of a tree that are being blown by the wind, as though your arm has no muscular effort of its own. It's just being blown by your breath. And bring that hand back to the floor. Go to the other side. Inhale it out and up. Exhale, thread it through. As you exhale that arm through, the bottom arm can stay straight or it can bend, just depending on what feels better to you. One more. Good. Bring that hand back to the floor. Now we're going to step one foot forward. And here also, if you're next to a couch or a table or anything, come up, you can use the couch to hold onto to help you get your balance. We'll step one foot through, come up to kneeling. So we're not really lunging here, we're just kneeling. We'll start out nice and tall and relaxed. Take a breath in. And as you exhale, let yourself sink down into more of a lunge, shifting your hips towards your front foot. And as you come into this, walk the front foot forward a little bit, so that the knee stays right on top of the heel and the ankle. What we don't want, and you can look at yourself, we don't want to over hyperflex the knee. Knees don't really love that when you do that long term. So we'll protect the knee, keeping the knee at a 90 degree angle. And then forget all of that, forget the rules, and just be here and breathe in it. If your body is up and down, your upper body is perpendicular to the floor, you feel pretty equal stretch, probably, here in the hamstring of the front leg, and then in the quadricep and hip flexor of this back leg. And you can play with it. If you come forward more, you feel it more in the front leg. When you push back more, you feel it more in the back leg. Every pose is like a starting point for play and exploration to see where your stretch is, where you feel it. One more breath. And exhale, bring your hands down to the floor to support you. Rock back on this heel, so we're and walking the hands back. Coming into a hamstring stretch. So we're flexing this foot back. The leg is fairly straight. It doesn't have to be locked straight. If you've got a bend in it, fantastic. It doesn't matter. If you're feeling the hamstring stretch, you're right where you need to be. So find that space where you feel the stretch, and breathe. Again, keeping the spine pretty neutral, so we're not straining the back. One more breath here. Good, now bend the knee and drag the foot back. Bring the knee back down to the floor. Nice and gentle. And then we'll switch. Other foot. Hold on to something to help you get that foot up if you need to. We'll come up nice and tall. Take a big, tall, filling breath in. And as you exhale, sink down, shifting your weight forward. And as I go forward, you can kind of see my knees almost coming over my foot. So I'm going to walk my toes forward to protect my knee. I've already had one knee surgery. I don't really want to have another, so I try to always be mindful of my knees. And sit there. Find all the little places in your hips, thighs, and your groin where you might be holding on and protecting. And see if as you exhale, you can let those places go. as far back as it'll go. Take a breath here. And exhale, folding forward. And when we fold forward, we're thinking of belly to the thigh more than nose to the knee. Breathe into the stretch. This is the kind of stretch that the hamstrings are tight. And a stretch like this, sometimes you kind of want to get out of. See if you can breathe through it, just a couple of breaths. And feel that. One more breath here. Good. Exhale. Bend the knee. Drag your foot back. And knee goes back to the floor. Let's bring the hands to the floor, to your mat. We're going to come up into downward facing dog. And there's a couple of ways to do this. So traditional, regular old downward facing dog, we curl the toes under, and we'll straighten out the legs, lifting our bottom up towards the ceiling or sky, and then walk the feet back away from our hands. And then here, you can play with it. You can march your legs in place, bend one knee, and then bend the other. I'm going to take my knees down. But another way to do it is up on blocks or even up on a couch or a table. So if you are really tight, and when you go into downward facing dog, if your lower back hurts, if your legs hurt, if it feels completely wrong, put your hands up on the couch or a coffee table, something higher, and you're still getting all this stretch through the backs of the legs. That's okay. Downward dog isn't about what it looks like. It's about protecting your back, protecting your body with good alignment, and finding that stretch. And at any time, if I'm taking too long here, feel free to put your knees down and rest, and then you can go right back up, don't worry. All right, take one more breath here. I probably talked way too long and you're tired of being in down dog. Now, let's breathe in, bend the knees. Exhale, walk your feet up towards your hands. And you can rise up to standing. And if you need to, always look out for the back. Bring your hands to your thighs to help you stand up if you need. We don't want you wrenching your back and throwing it out. So here in standing, feet can be hip distance apart. They can be together. Doesn't matter. Go to where your balance is. We'll come into a few sun salutes. Inhale, arms reach up high in the sky. Exhale, hands to heart and fold forward, keeping that neutral spine, fingertips to the floor or to the coffee table or the couch or blocks. Or you can also just bend your knees. Bend your knees as much as you need to comfortably bring your toes, your fingers to the ground. You don't ever want to strain. And then rise back up. Inhale, Tadasana. Exhale, forward fold. Let's do a few more of those. Every time we inhale, we're stretching the whole front of the body. And as we exhale, we're stretching the back of the body. These in the morning, you do this in the morning, just these sun salutes up and down, almost as good as a cup of coffee. Almost. Not better, but close. Gets your blood pumping and energizes you. Do one more. Exhale, forward fold. Rise up. This time we're going to bring our arms up and then bend the knees a little bit. We're coming into chair pose. So you can see here, my upper body is perfectly straight, just like I was standing up. The only thing different is the bend in the knees. Arms up, and what I like to do here, instead of arms reaching up high, I like to bend my elbows, cactus arms, or here in Texas we think of goalposts, pull your elbows back, and that gives you this opening across your chest and through the shoulders. We're undoing that all day desk and driving computer posture that we're in all the time. Any opportunity we have to open that up. Thighs are probably shaky. You probably feel starting to feel a little bit prickly sweaty. That's okay. One more breath.
straighten your legs. Now let's take a step back with one of your legs. Doesn't matter which one. We'll come onto the toes and the ball of the back foot. Other foot, front foot facing straight ahead to the top edge of your mat. And press the heel down into the ground. Doing it that way, we're ensuring that the back foot is facing almost as straight ahead as the front foot. So we don't want it out at an angle like that. That's bad for the knees. So turn that foot in, facing almost straight ahead. Inhale, arms come up. Exhale, bend the front knee. We're coming into Warrior One. Doesn't matter how far apart your feet are if you take a wide stance. Some people do that. You don't have to. Go to where it feels good for you. And then notice your breathing as you stand here. Feeling the breath come in. We're feeling how light and buoyant we are, like we could just float up to the sky. But every time we exhale, you feel how grounded you are to the earth. Feet and toes pressing into the floor. Your thighs are pushing like we wanted to push the floor away from our feet. All at the same time, these opposites of the lightness and the weight. Now lower your arms down. Let's take a few filling breaths as we sweep the arms back. Big circles. Inhale, hands touch. Exhale, hands down. And again. One more. Let your arms down. You're going to open up to the side, setting up for Warrior Two. Warrior Two, our feet are going to come into a right angle to each other, a 90-degree angle. The foot that was in the front is going to stay exactly like it was, pointing towards the top edge of the mat. The other foot will face the long edge of the mat now. Heel lines up to the arch of the foot. When you're ready and you've got your feet where you want them to be, inhale, arms out. And exhale, bend the knee that's pointing towards the top edge of the mat. So I'm in right leg warrior two. So my right foot faces straight ahead, my right knee is bent, and my hips are sort of at an angle towards the right. Feel the space that you take up in this pose. Feel how tall you are. Feel your head lifting up towards the sky. Feel your feet pulling down, rooting you in place into the earth. Feel how wide your wingspan is. Pulling hands apart, stretching open the chest. One more breath here. Now let's go in and out of Warrior Two. We'll inhale, reach the arms up high, straighten the knee. Exhale, sink back down. Keep that moving. Every time I teach this class to someone for the first time, I always like to tell the story of what this reminds me of. If you've ever been to a butterfly museum and seen a butterfly hatch out of its chrysalis, it comes out and its wings are wet and crumpled and weak and it can't fly yet. So it sits there and it just opens its wings, it unfurls them and opens and closes them, letting them dry and strengthen. So when I do this, I always think of a butterfly getting ready to fly for the very first time, and how strong and powerful that is, and how beautiful. One more time. And exhale, come back to Warrior Two. Good. Our legs are going to stay right where they are. We're going to drop the left arm to the left leg, if you've got your right knee bent. Other arm up towards the ceiling, coming into reverse warrior. We're not bending through the back here. This is just through the waist, just coming over, a little bit of an arch through our side waist. And breathing, feeling this whole side opening, the ribs expanding, stretching. One more breath. exhale, come back into warrior two, and we'll keep coming towards the right side, or whichever side is your bent knee. Bring the right, the wrist or the forearm or even the hand to the top of the thigh. Other arm reaching up high, extended side angle pose. And everybody's looks different. So your extended side angle might be here with your hand on your leg. If you bend farther, it might be your wrist or even your forearm. You see how my legs are going deeper? But it doesn't matter. It's all the same pose. So if you're right here, perfect. Go to where it feels good and it's still a little bit challenging to you. Take one more breath here. Good. Now bring the palm to the top of the thigh. If it wasn't there already, straighten that leg. And then we're going to push this hip out to the side a little bit more and slide into triangle. And here it changes from a leg strengthening to this big stretch in the inner thigh. Breathe here. Again, this leg does not have to be locked straight. It can have that little bend in it. That's okay. If you have tight hamstrings or tight back, bending the knees some is a way to protect yourself. That's good. One more breath. Good. Use this bottom hand on the thigh to help push yourself back up to standing. Bring the pointed out foot forward, so both feet are facing straight ahead now. And we'll fold forward into wide-legged forward fold. So fold forward, keeping the spine neutral. Coming to put the hands on the floor, or again, the coffee table, the couch, the kitchen counter, whatever helps you fold forward to the degree that you can go to, so that you don't have to miss this great pose. And you can also a yoga block under your hands. You can take your feet as wide as they'll go, comfortably, and then just let everything soften and hang. We're stretching the inner thighs, still getting some hamstring and back. And if it feels good, you can wiggle around, bend your knees, just like we do in downward dog. One more breath here. Bring the feet a little bit closer, maybe put some bend in the knees, hands to your thighs to help push yourself back up. And let's spin everything around. So we're facing the opposite side of the mat now. So now I'm doing my left leg, so you do the opposite front leg of what you were doing before. So my foot was naturally kind of out here since I just spun around, so I'm going to check it and I'm going to pivot it on the heel like I'm swinging a door shut. Pivot it forward. So it's almost facing as straight ahead as the other foot. That keeps my hips squared, that makes the knees happy. Everything's facing towards the back of my mat. And now I'm ready. So inhale, bring your arms up. And exhale, bend that front knee. And all those rules and all the stuff I said last time, let it go out of your head and just be here. Be here and feel this pose and enjoy it. Feel that slight shift in your body as you inhale and the shift back as you exhale. Kind of like a rocking boat on still water. It's still slightly rocking. One more breath. Let the arms soften and hang down beside you. Now big circles. Inhale, sweep the arms back. Hands touch above the head. Exhale and down. Notice how fully your lungs fill up as you breathe in. Completely different than when you're sitting behind a desk at a computer all day. Or when you're driving. Exhale that arm down. Now, same thing as before. Let's open out to the side. You can go right into your warrior two, or arms down. Take a minute to set yourself up. Now the leg that we're going to be bending, that foot is facing the back edge of the mat. Other foot facing the long edge of the mat. Feet lining up with each other at a 90 degree angle. And then go inhale, arms out and wide. And exhale, bend the knee. Always adjust it. If you're standing in a way that feels too easy, if you're right here and not really feeling it a lot, creep that bent knee creep the toes out farther, then sink down and notice the difference, or even take them out wider, sink a little deeper. So this pose can be done so many different ways, so many different degrees, just depending on what your body needs. So take it to where your body needs it to be. One more breath here. And now let's go into the butterfly wings move. Inhale, arms up straight in the knee. Exhale, sink back down. Keep that moving. Stretching out our wings. Drawing them. Strengthening them. Getting ready to fly for the very first time. Isn't that kind of what yoga is all about? Looking for our first flight, or maybe our next flight. Looking for how strong we are, what we're capable of, not just physically, but mentally and emotionally. One more breath in, and exhale out. Good. Keep the legs right here in Warrior Two. We're just bending through the waist. Drop the hand to the back leg. Other arm lifts up to the ceiling. Breathe here. There's all this lengthening and opening and expansion in the side ribs. Let the other side just relax and hang. There's no reason to try to pull down farther. One more breath. Exhale back into Warrior Two. Come into extended side angle. So it might be here, other arm up. If you bend over farther, you might have your wrist or forearm. Might even have your elbow. Doesn't matter. Be there and breathe. Bring the palm to the thigh if it wasn't already there. Straighten out that leg. Push this hip out to the side a little bit. Just kind of cocking it out like you want to put your hand on your hip. And slide into your triangle. And my legs may be a lot farther apart than yours are. That's okay. Triangle, it doesn't matter how far apart your feet are. If you're feeling this inner thigh stretch and all the stretch through the hip on the other side, you're good. Your hand to help push you back up to standing. And very gently, heel toe your feet a little closer together. We're going to take ourselves down all the way onto the mat. We'll start out on our tummies. So lay all the way down. And keep your hands, your arm, elbows right under your shoulders, hands out in front of you. Inhale, this is called Sphinx, because that's just what we look like here. Wherever you are, if your shoulders are slumped forward, pull them back just a little bit more than where they were. So we're looking to start opening the chest and the front shoulders, but it doesn't always happen overnight. Sometimes that's really sore because our shoulders and chest aren't used to doing that. So incrementally, every little bit makes a difference. You can kind of feel the muscle between your shoulder blades squeezing together. One more breath. Good. And let all that down. You can rest your chin on your forearms. Bend your knees and kick your feet back and forth. A little bit of a windshield wiper or circles. It always feels good to do that after you arch your back. And then let your legs down. We're going to do a couple. Each leg, we're going to do a stretch of the hip flexor. So I'm going to leave my bottom arm down to support me. I'm going to reach back and grab this ankle and pull my heel towards my bottom. And I didn't say you have to touch your bottom. You might be right here and you're going to feel all this stretch through here. So just go to where it'll go and breathe into it. When we hold our breath, muscles can't relax. It's when we exhale that everything can soften and stretch a little bit better. Take another breath here. Exhale, let that foot go down, and then we'll switch other side. Reach back with the other hand. And gently pull heel towards your bottom. Help yourself roll over onto your back. Lay all the way down. We're going to keep the legs bent with the feet flat on the ground. And lift up into bridge. Arms down by your sides with the palms flipped up. And that helps the shoulders open and fall back into the floor. And on an in-breath, lift your bottom up off the floor. Hip bones pushing up towards the ceiling. And then my favorite part, you can kind of walk your shoulder blades a little closer together, kind of like somebody was tucking you in, tucking a blanket around your shoulders. We're going to bring the shoulder blades even closer together. We're trying to bring the back up to at least neutral. If your back goes even higher than that, fine, but at least to a flat back neutral spine. You can watch your belly rise and fall, just reminding you to keep breathing, especially exhaling. And as you exhale, gently let your back and bottom all the way back down to the floor. Good. You can rock your knees side to side, work that out. Okay, knees come back to the center. Take one leg straight out to the floor. It doesn't matter which one because we're going to do both of them. This is a really nice, gentle abdominal strengthening. So as we breathe, we'll inhale the straight leg up, but only as high as the other thigh. So don't bring it all the way up here. It's going to be equal to the other thigh. Exhale it all the way back down. But don't let it go. Don't release it. As soon as you breathe again, pick it back up. Exhale it down. And just listen to your breath, moving your leg up and down. We're pulling the leg longer with the foot, pulling the foot far away. So we're lengthening the quadricep and the hip flexors inside. One more breath, up and down. And then release that leg all the way to the floor. Bend it, put your foot on the floor, and switch. Other leg gets a turn. Breathe it up and down. A really nice way to gently work the abdominals, the lower abdominals, but also the sides without the intensity and difficulty of sit-ups and crunches. If you dig your fingers in, you can feel your abs rock hard in your belly. They're really working right now. One more. Inhale, breath up and down. Exhale, let that let go. Bend the knee, put the foot on the ground. Let everything relax a little bit. Pick your knees up, and pick your feet up. Hold on to your knees or the tops of your shins. Very gently hug your knees towards your chest. And for me, it always takes a few breaths. It takes a few seconds to let my lower back let go and really relax here. When it starts out, it's a little bit tight. So I'm not going to force it, or I will be in bed with a heating pad on my back. So just breathe. Let the lower back soften. Let the hips and thighs soften. Starting to feel everything slowing down. Now keep holding onto your knees, and we're going to open the knees, letting them just fall open to wherever they fall. You can keep your hands right here on your knees, or reach through and grab your ankles, your feet, or my favorite, the big toes. Let the feet widen apart, and you can rock side to side. This is called Happy Baby, because this is exactly what babies do. They find their feet, and they play, and it's just a feel-good place to be. Breathe as you rock. Take one more breath here. Now come back to center. Bring your feet back together. Let them go down to the floor. And let both knees flop gently over to one side. And arms can be up on your tummy, on your ribcage, or they can flop out wide. Do whatever feels good. And you can see, knees aren't going to stay together. Your feet aren't going to stay together. This is a very informal spinal twist and last little stretch. And you'll feel it in this whole side. Last few breaths. Bring your knees back to center, and rolling your back onto the floor, and you might pick up your bottom, sort of readjust your back, flop over to the other side. Breathe here, enjoy the way that feels. Carefully and gently bring your knees back to the center. Let your back be flat on the ground. And we'll come into the final pose, which is the best pose of this whole practice, Shavasana, which is translated into corpse pose. So really just as though you're asleep. You can take your legs out straight, arms down by your sides, or you can bring them up. But if you lay here long, that may start to pull in your lower back. So what I love to do is get a big, heavy couch cushion or bolster and stick it right here under my knees. And then my knees are supported, feet flat on the ground. And then I can really let go and rest. So close your eyes. If you can, grab something. A towel, anything to be an eye mask, lay it across your eyes. The weight of something across your eyelids sends a signal to the optic nerve, calm down, there's nothing to look at right now. It helps your brain relax. And as you lie here, feel all the work that your body just did. Notice the difference in the way you feel now compared to before you started. Let yourself feel heavy, sinking into your mat, feeling the ground beneath you rising up to hold you, cushion you. When I teach classes in my studio, this is where I prop people up with a blanket under their head and props everywhere. So if you're at home, find some stuff, couch cushions, pillows, whatever you got, legs up on the sofa, anything just to help you really fully relax and sink down into the floor. This is the part of the practice people tend to skip or rush through. This is really the most important part. Giving yourself a moment to find that rest, to find that peace. While everything around you is going full speed, so many things to do and plan, so much work to get done, it's easy for us to forget how to be still, how to slow our minds, how to truly let go and relax our bodies. Stay here as long as you want. You can pause me. And when you're finished, we'll gently come back up to sitting up. We'll start by rolling over to one side. Just like you're in bed asleep and you just want 5 more minutes to rest, bring an arm up under your head to let you rest. Take a breath and let it out. And then use your arms, press your top hand into the floor, and use your arm strength to help push your upper body up. Use the other hand, always protecting the back. Find your way back into sitting up, letting your body come to a more awake state than what it was while you were resting. Listen to your breath, just like we started. Feel everything that you're feeling in your body. Find the places in your body that feel good right now. It might even be just the feeling of your breath coming and going. Deepak Chopra said, "In the midst of chaos and movement, find stillness inside of you." That's what we do when we come to the yoga mat, when we come to our practice. We're telling the outside world and all the things around us, "I'm going to take this moment for myself." In the midst of movement and chaos, find stillness. Towards your fingertips, or you can pick your hands up and bring your thumbs to the space between your eyebrows. We usually close with the word namaste, and the word namaste means the light that is in me honors and shines on the light that is in you. So take one last breath